Welcome to this brief guide on how to use advanced filters and macros in Excel. Filtering data is one of the most common tasks done in Excel, and there are many ways in which you can do it, ranging from using the standard table filters through to the filter formula. But one of the ways that a lot of people don't know about is the advanced filter. Today I'll show you how to use that. Here you can see I have my sales data, and I'd need to filter it. In my case, I want to filter it by the category as well as the unit price. So I'd like to find out my audio products that have a price of more than $120. In order to do that the usual way, I would need to first filter it for the product itself. And then after doing this, I would then need to go over to the unit price and use a second filter to then try and filter it out for products that are higher than $120. Now, this is not super difficult to do that way. However, there's a way that I can do both of these filters all in one. So what I'd like to do here is use these filter fields that I've created in this little table here. I can do that by utilizing the advanced filters. To use the advanced filters, we head to the Data tab in our ribbon, and about halfway along, we'll have an option in the Filters category, right next to the usual filter button. We can see a button there that says Advanced. Selecting this is going to open up our advanced filters. Now here you can see we have the option to filter the list in its existing place or copy it to another location. And then we need to select the list range. So in this case, we're going to select that entire table for all of my data so that we have our chosen array. Then I need to show it where the criteria is that I want it to filter by. So here I'm going to select my filter table. Once done, I can then choose to hit OK. And then you'll see in just a moment, there we go. My table has now been filtered and I have my audio products that are more than $120. Now, the question here though is, what if I then need to change my filter options? So say for instance, I want to remove that unit price and just have all of my audio products. What I can see here is that my table hasn't updated. So this isn't really useful to me. How do I get my table here to update with my new filters? I simply head back to that data tab, and I'll notice that the reapply button is actually grayed out, so I can't use this. So what I need to do is actually select the advanced option again, and then simply click on OK to reapply my filters. Now that's one way to do it, but having to do that all the time isn't great. So what I'm going to do is we're going to create a macro to be able to automate this. Here you'll see it's in the View tab, but if you're on Windows, it'll be in the Developer tab. Once we've found our tab, we head all the way to the end there and we have the option that says Record Macro. Selecting this is going to ask us to then name our macro. And in this case, I'm going to name mine Refresh Table. There is a key thing here. You need to make sure that there are no spaces in the name of your macro, otherwise it will not accept it. You then have the option to set a keyboard shortcut if you'd like to. I'm going to leave that blank in this case and we're going to select OK. Now we need to record our macro. So for my macro, I need to select the Data tab, select the Advanced option, and select OK. Now that I've recorded my macro, I need to stop the recording, so I head back to that Record Macro section, and now select the option that says Stop Recording. Now we'll see that if I click on the View Macros button, I can see that I have my Refresh Table macro there, ready to be used. Close this window down, and now, how do we use that macro? One of the things that we can look at doing is heading to the Insert tab in our ribbon, and then we can head to the Shapes section, and then we're going to insert a shape, and we're going to convert this shape into a button. And that button will house our macro. So I've selected the rounded rectangle shape, and I'm going to create my shape right here. And then I have the option to input some text, which will be great if I share this table out to someone so that they can know exactly what this button is designed to do. And now that I have my text there, all I need to do is simply select my shape, and to link the macro to it, I simply right click, and in the context menu, I select the option there that says Assign Macro. Selecting this button is then going to give me a prompt showing me the available macros that I have, and I'm going to select my option that says Refresh Table. Select OK, and now my macro has been applied. So let's adjust the filters and test out our button. We're going to select Televisions, and click on our Refresh Table button, and in no time at all, our table has now been refreshed with the brand new filters. And to show this again, I can select Photography, and then we head over to the unit price, and let's say items that are higher than $100. We can then simply hit refresh table, and there's our products as well. And we can take this one step further by adding in a third filter area by putting something like camera into the product ordered section, hitting our refresh table button, and there you go. Now, the only thing we're missing here is a way to get back to our original table. So to clear the filters, we simply remove all of the items from our filter table right here, hit the button to run our macro again, and there we are, back to our full table. And that's how you use advanced filters and macros in Excel. I hope you found this tip extremely useful, and it saves you plenty of time in the future, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.